You're listening to the Quint's podcast.
Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi's term of office is nearly over, and with it some long-running legal sagas at the Supreme Court. One of these which isn't over, however, is the Sabarimala temple controversy. CJI Gogoi decided that the issues at play in the review petitions filed against its 2018 judgment allowing women of all ages to enter the temple needed to be answered by a larger bench of at least 7 judges. The review petitions have therefore been left pending till this larger bench of judges can decide on these issues, not just for the Sabarimala case but also for other cases challenging ostensibly discriminatory religious practices as well. You're listening to The Big Story, and I'm your host, Shalvari. The verdicts have been coming thick and fast in the Supreme Court in the run-up to CJI Gogoi's retirement on 17 November, and today it was the turn of the Sabarimala and the Rafael review petitions. While in the case of Rafael, the court shot down the review petitions that had been filed against its earlier judgment, where the court had said that it wouldn't interfere in the aircraft deal. In the case of Sabarimala, it's a bit more messy. Most of you will remember that back in 2018, the Supreme Court had allowed entry of women of all ages into the Sabarimala temple, right? And then protesters were severely upset because they felt that this violated their sacred traditions and beliefs. If you recall reading reports from that year, things got a bit out of hand, with devotees resorting to even violence to stop women from entering the temple. And then 65 petitions, including 4 fresh writ petitions and review petitions from parties like the Tantri or the head priest of the temple, the Nair Service Society and the Travancore Devaswam board were filed against the verdict. They all said that the court had got it wrong in its earlier judgment, that it hadn't appreciated the religious rights of the devotees, and so the judgment should be overturned on review. And that's what today was supposed to settle. The judges were either supposed to say that they got it right back then, so the review petitions had to be dismissed, or say that, you know what, we got it wrong, here's what should have really happened. But like I said, the matter hasn't been settled. In fact, it's become bigger than just the entry of female devotees in Sabarimala. What does it exactly mean? I'll come to that, but let's address the most important question. The court didn't really say anything about it, but are women still allowed inside the temple, or is that off the table while this larger bench decides what to do? This is Vakasha, the Quint's legal editor, who's come straight from the court, and he explains where the entry of women devotees stand right now.
So, the important thing to remember is that as of this moment, because the review petitions have not been decided by the court, the old judgment, the 2018 judgment, still stands and is still in effect. And that's very, very important to remember here.
Want to hear the rest of this podcast? Check out the link to the full episode in the description below and follow The Quint on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, JioSaavn, and all other platforms we are on.